Just so you know, this relatively long video will have chapters or time codes for different sections on YouTube, visible near the timeline. RFID tags come in many shapes and forms. Key fobs and cards are probably ones that most people recognize and think about when they think about RFID tags. There are also these thin stickers which can be attached to products and packages. Professional RFID solutions for access control and industrial applications may cost quite a lot, but we don't need to pay a huge amount of money to use RFID tags in our own projects like home automation systems. My RFID module came from sponsor of this video PCBWAY.com. You can order many different modules, components, and accessories from their module store along with your next PCB order. In addition to cheap PCBs at $5 plus shipping, you can order different modules from their module store, and they will ship it to you in the same package with the PCBs. You can also order copies of PCBs shared by PCBWAY's customers on their shared projects section. For up-to-date information on their offering and pricing, go check out PCBWAY.com. So I got this RC522 module for whopping $2, including the module itself, pin header, and two different shaped tags. I have few ideas how I might use this in future, but for now, I'll focus on connecting this to Home Assistant. Home Assistant is running on my server, and this will be a separate device, using ESP8266. Knowing how popular this module is, I knew I wouldn't need to read the datasheet and write the low-level code for it. Instead, there would be an Arduino library to make using these modules easier. There are many such libraries, but there is something even better for using this with Home Assistant. There's a way to create ESP8266 or ESP32-based smart devices with just few lines of simple code. Before diving into software side, I have connected the RC522 module to Wemos D1 Mini. I have selected pins from D5 to D8 for the SPI interface. Without hardware modifications, this RFID module uses only SPI interface. There are I2C and UART interfaces on the chip, but using them requires hardware modification on the specific module. Reset and interrupt pins are not needed in this case. This is early state of my Home Assistant dashboard. I have couple of lights and scenes to control them all at once. In this video I want to know from Home Assistant which RFID tag is near the reader, and as a test, control one of my lights by turning it on when tag is present and off when it's not present. I have installed add-on for ESPHome on my Home Assistant. ESPHome is great for connecting ESP8266 or ESP32 to Home Assistant. From their website, ESPHome is a system to control your microcontrollers by simple yet powerful configuration file and control them remotely through home automation systems. So this is used to create firmware to the ESP modules. Instead of writing Arduino compatible sketches like I have used to doing, this allows us to create home automation gadgets much easier. People have created different components which are like libraries. Someone has written the required code, and thanks to those components we can use different sensors and other peripherals with couple lines of code in the configuration file. As an example, let's check AM2320 temperature and humidity sensor component. What we need to write an ESPHome configuration file to get these temperature and humidity information sent to the Home Assistant. This type of configuration is all it takes. That will automatically read the temperature and humidity and send them to the server, and Home Assistant can display them with the names defined in the ESPHome configuration. Well, how about the RC522 module? That is much more complicated module, and therefore that must need more complicated code as well, right? Well, let's see the component page on the ESPHome website. ESPHome can read the UID from the tag. UID is the unique ID of the tag, which is all I need. I don't need to use any other features of the RFID tags for now. It's enough to detect which tag is near the reader. Example on that page has 11 or so lines of code. And actually, these 7 lines are enough to make this work and get the UID from the RFID tag printed on the lock on the home assistant. These four lines are for creating binary sensor, which can be used as present or not present style sensor for showing if the specific tag is present. By defining this in the ESPHome configuration, means we don't need to handle the UIDs in the home assistant. Instead, we get the on-off sensor with nice name we have defined here. This project seems to be much easier than I thought. Back in the home assistant, where I have ESPHome add-on installed and available on the left panel, I can create the configuration and flash it to the ESP8266 module from the browser. Clicking new device tells that during the first installation the device, or the ESP8266 module, needs to be connected using USB cable, and because I don't have HTTPS configured, it has to be connected to the server. But there's alternative, which is fine. So I have the USB connected to this laptop that I'm using, not the server that is running the Home Assistant. I'm using that alternative way, so I click Open ESPHome Web on the bottom. From this web page, I can connect to the ESP device that I have plugged in to the USB port. Clicking Connect pops up a window asking for serial port. I'm using Chrome. I don't know how this looks in different browsers. I'll select the correct COM port from the list and click Connect. As informed, this will install the basic version of ESPHome to your device and help you connect to your network. After installing this basic version, firmware can be updated wirelessly over Wi-Fi. So installing this basic version doesn't take long, and once it has been installed, pop-up will automatically open and Wi-Fi network and password can be set. So the wireless installation and connection in general works in the future. When that is done and I go back to Home Assistant ESPHome page, new device can be seen being discovered. To be able to configure and program it from this Home Assistant, I'll click Adopt. It will create ESPHome configuration for this device, and here the default name that is shown isn't really user-friendly, so I'll rename it to something more appropriate, something that I remember being this device. For example, RC522. I'll click Install to install the initial configuration to the module. Installation is done, and I can see the RC522 named ESPHome device. I'll hit Edit on the bottom of the device and the default configuration opens up. Very first thing to do is changing the used port. This affects, for example, what size flash memory the ESPHome thinks the port has. Hovering the mouse over the port name shows an info pop-up, and there is a link to this web page that has variable names for many different ports. I have VMOS D1 Mini, so I'll search VMOS. And there's this VMOS D1, R2 and Mini, which is the correct one. Icon next to it copies the variable name. That variable name can then be pasted into the configuration file to replace the ESP01-1M, which wasn't correct. If port with too little flash is selected, over-the-air updates might not work due to ESPHome thinking there's not enough space in the flash memory. Configurations we saw on the components page at the ESPHome homepage can be added to the bottom of this configuration file. I added the SPI section defining the CLK, MISO and MOSI pins that I'd like to use, and RC522_SPI section with CS pin and update interval I'd like to use. To upload this, I'll hit Save and install on top right corner and select wirelessly to upload the firmware over the Wi-Fi. I'm running Home Assistant on old Raspberry Pi, and this compilation that is compiling lots of libraries for the first time takes multiple minutes. But that's fine. Small edits to the configuration won't require recompiling all the libraries, and only the necessary ones will be compiled again. But once the firmware has been compiled and uploaded, the reader can now be used to read UIDs from the RFID tags. The log is left open and I can see the new tag message with the UID printed on the log. Key fob and card have different UIDs as expected, and the UID string can be copied from this log to Notepad or other place and used in the configuration file in the next step. I happen to have some RFID tag stickers. I'll test if they are compatible with this reader. They seem to be compatible, just something to notice that the UID is longer than on the tags that came with the reader. There are different types of tags available, so if you are going to buy this module and extra tags, check what tags are compatible with this module. Next, I will edit the configuration by adding the binary sensor section that was seen on the RC522 component page in the ESPHome homepage. I have two binary sensors defined with RC522 as platform and the UIDs from the previous test when those UIDs got printed on the log. Both tags get more user-friendly name. Installing this doesn't take as long as before, because most of the internal source codes are already compiled and only some parts need to be recompiled. Now the edited version is uploaded and if I read these tags, the UIDs won't be printed, but the given name and state either being on or off, on being present and off being not present. Obviously, it will tell the correct name that is given for the tag with specific UID. So now I'm getting information on Home Assistant if the tag is present. I do one more thing and create an automation that will switch light on when the tag is present. From left panel, settings, then devices, ESPHome's devices, and RC522. Easiest way to create automation triggered by this RFID reader is to click plus sign next to the automation's title and select which event triggers the automation. I will for example use the tag I named RFID key and I will create one automation for turning the light on when the tag comes near the reader and second automation turning the light off when tag is removed. Under actions I select device and I want to control and as action either turn on or turn off. After adding these two automations, they should automatically work. I'll go to the dashboard to see if the bedroom's light switch on and off based on presence of the RFID key fob. It was already on, so it started following the state changes after the first time removing the tag. One idea I had was preventing non-authorized people from using certain power tools. If instead of controlling bedroom light, I was controlling a smart outlet, this would already be suitable for that application. Power to the tool would only be on when the RFID of authorized person is in the reader. This video demonstrating how to set up this ESPHome project is probably about 15 minutes long. It took significantly more time just looking for the perfect Arduino library and how to use them, while this way I got exactly what I wanted with few lines of configurations instead of tens of lines of code and lots of debugging. I hope this was helpful in some way. See you next video. Thanks. Bye.